Sound design.
All right, so the next step in our audio analyzer verification checklist is just the settings for our audio analyzer, okay? And this is quick. I already went into more detail into all these settings in a previous video, but when I get into the field and I open Smaart or SatLive or whatever my audio analyzer is for the first time, I'm still gonna check these really quick. Okay, so I'll just hit option A and make sure that I have the correct input device, correct output device selected, and then I'll just check to see I have the correct number of inputs, that their friendly names are correct. I've got my reference input here, I've got my measurement microphone here, great. Check the microphone correction curve, none for the ref, obviously, and then I imported this one for my EMX7150. Okay, then I'll head over to the measurement config tab. I'll look at my default TF, and just make sure that I have the correct measurement signal and reference signal. This is really important, especially in Smaart DI, because I've noticed a problem with my version that for some reason these get flipped, even though I'll save this. So I'll click OK, I'll exit Smaart, I'll come back into it, and these will be flipped. Let's take a look at what that would look like if this were a problem. So if these were backwards, and I said OK, and then I took a measurement, here are two tips that this is a problem. Number one, just because it's big and bold here, this phase trace should not be sloping up from left to right. Okay, the normal pattern is for it to slope down from left to right, and then at some point it should flatten out. That's where the delay locator has locked on. My next tip is that my delay is actually a negative number, which is impossible. You can't have negative delay. What's going on here? What's going on here is that my reference and my measurement inputs have been flipped. If I go back to my measurement settings here, option G, measurement config, default TF, switch these, measurement signal, microphone, reference signal, reference loop, click OK, take a measurement. And you can see here that everything has flipped, right? And now it looks normal. Number one, the phase trace is sloping down from left to right as it should, and the delay is a positive number. Okay, so just a quick verification that our settings here are correct. One more thing that I might check, option M, signal generator, and just make sure that I have the correct device here and it's going out of the output. So I'm done with the settings for Smaart DI. In the next video, I'll do Smaart and then SatLive.
Sound design.